Hi viewers, in this video we are going to discuss about the PLC selection criteria. So in what is a PLC, programmable logic controller, where it is used in industries for automation systems and all. In the previous videos we have discussed. So in the later diagram, how we can get the circuits, how we can read the circuits, all the things we have discussed. Now PLC, when we are selecting for an industry or any operation applications, what are all the conditions, what are the criterias we have to check it? So these are all the PLC selection criteria. Okay, so very very important things are there. So let me see one by one. Before going for the selection of the PLC, first of all we should know for what purpose we are going to use it. So that's, we call it as a system requirement. So in what way, what is the final solutions we want? So the starting point is determining any solutions which what we are going to be achieve, okay, for any problems. And then we can decide into terms of small elements. Okay, just like assembly. So assembly line is my target. So assembly line, so what to do and how it should be done. So it should be divided into in terms of elements. So the task should be divided into elements, and each and elements, then it is so if you divide it easily into elements, it will be easy for description of what is the process to be done. So the number of elements, it's helpful for the description, more number of elements, right? Second one is application requirement. So how, where it is going to be applied. So first the system requirements we have studied, for what purpose we are going to do it. And application requirements, what are all the things is needed for it. So what are the input and output devices it's needed for finishing the task. Okay, it may be a switch, it may be an input device, or it may be a sensor, it may be an input device. And right side output device may be a motor, or output device may be a display, or output devices may be some other linear actuators. So what is the exact output, whether it is maybe linear movement or rotary movement, so I can make a rotary motor or it a linear actuator. And here we can operate through some other devices, what type of switches it should be. So the input and output devices requirements, this is called the application requirements. So what is the special actions or special operations over there, and for that operations, what are the functions required? So these are all the things we have to go with these application requirements. So once the system requirements is over, we have to concentrate on the application requirements. After that, what is the electrical requirements? Okay, I am selecting a switch, or I am selecting a cable of wires, or I am selecting a motor. So how much power it is required for moving, for the motor operation of the motor. So power inputs, these are all the things which is needed, and the device of the voltages, because the motor or what switch we are going to implement, for that it has to withstand for the given power. So the power and the motor is all interrelated. What we are going to work out, what we power is required for movement of the linear actuator or rotary actuator or whatever it is, the output device, for how much the electrical requirement, how much the power voltage requirements is there, that we have to determine. So that input output systems will work out on that. And next to the requirement is the speed of the operation. Okay, if I am going to use the PLC for a conveyor belt or a material transferring mechanism, so the transferring mechanism should be very slow or it should be very fast. So on what speed it has to move per minute, so that operation time we have to, and moreover the it has to wait for some time the further process. So a machine operates, so what is the time of the machine operation, cycle time, that we have to know. And that's what, this is the fastest time, which one is the fastest time it will take, because other entire devices ought to be operated according to the one particular timing. So it may be fastest action or it's the slowest one. So input device detection to the output device we need. Okay, so this is what very important, to speed of operation. So to control the system, we need what is the speed requirements. Okay, and next, what the thing is, communication. The communication requirements or communication, the thing is PLC or system, how we are going to connect with the input and output devices. So input devices may be a switch or some other cases, and output devices, linear actuator or rotary actuators or whatever it is, how we are going to connect with that. So either with the help of a paired wire, a twisted pair wire, or remotely we can operate somewhere else, we can use it by remote control operator or by radio modem. These are all modes of transferring the data from one to another. So electronic devices from input to output, because it may work under any hazardous environment where a man cannot go and enter and operate. So from some outside stations, we can operate with the computer control system, and we can operate with the radio devices all. So this how it is going to be involved. So communication requirements, that criteria we have to concentrate on. And the operator interface. Operator is going to work with these machines. So how it the machines can be operated with the help of the operator. So either it may be a button swipe or any LED switches or any displays is required. So interface is the thing which is having a information processing between the machine and the operator. So how he can give the data, how he can input the data, and how he can get the input output data. So this is what the interfaces required. So normally operators requires the push buttons, switches, momentary button switches, like that switches we used to go and do it. And the what output is the lights. Once this is signal, once the operation is done, it will show the signal of the light. So from that light we can come to know that the operation has been done. So alarms or any displays, counters, displays which is needed for the information from the device to the operator. So some electronics devices are there which just what it helps the messages about the machine, just like text descriptive test, it is done. So whatever the information needed over from the machine, it will show as a display, so that we can give it. Okay, and counting, counters, timings, and trackers, alarms, everything is there. This is what the operator and computer interface is going to be happen. And next one is the physical environment where this PLC is going to be located. So in any industries we are going to use this, but where we are going to locate it promptly, that is needed. Because if we keep these PLCs and it is to be maintained in a proper way, and if there is any errors out there, it has to be rectified. So as passages should be given, provided for the rectification process, and this will be helpful for keeping the control system in a proper manner. So this is the what are the criteria, PLC criterias are there for selection of the selection criterias. So once again I will tell this, what are the criteria, in the sense, first system requirement, then application requirement, electrical requirement, then what is the physical environment, what we are going to do, and what is the interface or communications in between, how it is to be communicated between the operator and the programmers, devices and all. So these are all the important PLC selection criteria. Okay, in the next we are going to see about these background of these actuators. So integration, next level of these PLCs, how it is going to be integrated with automation systems, and integration means what are the other devices which is used for the integration, the robotics and all, we are going to see in the next videos. Thank you.